All right, well, probably the shock of the rock world this week in Australia was the fact that Glenn Shorrock has decided to leave LRB and was replaced by Johnny Farnham, which came as a great shock to me because I thought, number one, John was doing very well as a solo artist with his own band, and also a shock that, you know, Glenn had decided to leave LRB. Anyhow, I believe that both parties are very, very happy. There's no squabble amongst John or Glenn, certainly not at all. And in fact, both Glenn and John with LRB are in the studios. Glenn's doing a solo album, and I believe that's coming along very well. And John is already with LRB in the studios in Melbourne doing an album with them. So we wish them both luck with their careers, and it's about time John was recognised over in America, and I think this may be the chance to do it. So best of luck, Johnny. All right, listen, coming up on Tuesday night, and you must write this down because it's a great new rock show on ABC television going to 186 stations right across Australia, and no one can beat that, is a program called Rock Arena. It starts at 10 to 10 on Tuesday night, and believe me, there's some great rock and roll every Tuesday night from now on ABC television. The first show will feature the Kinks. Let's have a look at the Kinks in the show. You really got me. Rock Arena, Tuesday night, 10 to 10 across Australia on ABC television. And believe me, it'll be a great rock show every Tuesday night. All right, talking about the Kinks, Ray Davies I had lunch with this week, and Ray is going to come on the show in a couple of weeks' time to talk to us. Also, hold on, his girlfriend and the group from The Pretenders, Chrissie, which is Ray's girlfriend, they are in fact coming out to Australia. They'll be on Countdown, and Chrissie will be comparing the show with myself. And also, Shakin Stevens is coming out to Australia, and he's also going to compare Countdown. And talking about Shakin Stevens, he has got some Lulus of some songs. Here's the new one, Oh Julie, yet again top 10 in England. We'll be top 10 here. Let's have a look at Shakin Stevens and the tour dates. Well, there you go. I'm sure Shakin will have everyone shaking in the aisles when he comes out to Australia. All right, we're going to review some Australian product this week. The Church have got their album out. They were on the show last week. And it's called The Blurred Crusade, and there's nothing blurred about this album. I thought they were one of the hot groups in 1981. They are going to sort of really cement themselves, not only on the charts, but as a rock group within Australia in 1982. They're a great group, great songwriters, and great on record. All right, watch out for The Church with The Blurred Crusade. And Peter Cupples, who was also on the show last week, has got Fear of Thunder out, his album, and believe me, there's some top producers got this album together with a top artist. Peter is a fine singer, also a very good songwriter, and I think it's about time that Peter Cupples, who without a doubt is one of the finest singers in this country, will be recognised not only here, but in America. All right, if you've been watching out with Adam and the Ant, with Antrap, you'll notice that Lulu, a lady that was was actually chopping the charts in England about 10 years ago, and in America, and in Australia, she actually features in the Adam and the Ant clip, but she's also got a single out herself. It's been a hit in the States, it's been a hit in England, probably because she's got a BBC series in England at the moment. Also in her BBC series is Alvin Stardust, another old rocker. So here is Lulu with I Could Never Miss You and Alvin Stardust with Pretend. Let's have a look at both of these clips.
And if you sing this melody, you'll be pretending just like me. The world is mine, it can be yours, my friend.
Well, there you go. That was Alvin. I got caught up with my own set. Alvin and Lulu. All right, the Countdown Awards are coming up on April the 18th, and it's going to be an award show not to miss. It runs for 1.5 hours, starts at 5:30 on Sunday night, April the 18th. And if you want to vote for your favourites, then I suggest you get out an envelope, address it Price Waterhouse, not Countdown, Post Office Box 208, Melbourne 3000, and on the back, not inside the envelope, you can vote for your most popular female, 1, 2 most popular male, 3 most popular group. Now, don't put it inside your envelope, all right? And believe me, that is going to be, the Countdown Awards is going to be a great show. We've already booked probably the top talent in the country, and we've got a few surprises up our sleeves for you from overseas. All right, quickly, this album, Mike Rudd and the Heaters, A great album again by a local group. I could not understand why The Animal was not a hit last year. That's on this album. It should have been. But if radio gives Laser Lover a go, I'm sure it's going to be a monster on the charts. Mike Rudd and the Heaters, so watch out for that one. All right, this I've also got this single out. Joe Kennedy, who is bound to be an overnight star. She stars in a movie called Starstruck, and they've got their first single out with Ned from The Restless Years. Here it is, Body and Soul, so watch out for that one. This group, without a doubt, that come from Sydney, not only were one of the finds, I guess, in 1981, but they are going to do what I think Men at Work did last year. I'll talk about Moving Pictures. They are an excellent group, and we are very proud to have them on the show. This single is already in the charts, and it's going to go like that. Here is Moving Pictures with What About Me.